Namaskar. Welcome to National Mission on Libraries, the capacity building program for public library personnel. This module will introduce you the activities and services of INFLIBNET Center. As you are aware, INFLIBNET Center stands for Information and Library Network. The first three letters of information, the first three letters of library, and the first three letters of network joining together, we get the abbreviation INFLIBNET. INFLIBNET is a center located in Gandhinagar, Gujarat, catering to the needs of research community and academician in the country, to the universities and colleges, which are all affiliated to University Grants Commission. That is why INFLIBNET is also known as an inter-university center of UGC, University Grant Commission. So next few minutes, I'll be taking you to the services which is provided by INFLIBNET Center, the activities conducted by INFLIBNET Center for the quality of education, and the tools and other mechanism developed by INFLIBNET Center which improve the access to the information which is required for academicians and research scholars. As I mentioned, INFLIBNET is located in Gandhinagar, and there is no other center for INFLIBNET Center in the country. But many of the universities are having a separate UGC INFLIBNET lab or division, which specifically take the content and resources from INFLIBNET Center. So university is also INFLIBNET name is associated. So let me start with what is the requirement of students, research scholar, or academicians? Suppose if I tell about a topic called knowledge management in libraries, what a student do, what a student does to get the information from any source. 10 or 20 years back, it was library. That is the first point of contact for information. Since technology and ICT, information and communication technologies, has gone much ahead to help students, what happened is ICT tools such as internet or browser, computer, people will use this for the information, and that becomes the source. Now, if I want to know about the title knowledge management in libraries, the easiest way for anybody is that search this knowledge management libraries, either as it take in full or take split the words into different keywords. The knowledge management in libraries can have knowledge, management, and library, three keywords. But the issue is that when I tried to search with management in the popular search engine Google, I get about 10 million, 1 billion hits, that is 106 crore hits. The results are located in the search box of Google. Now, that was the result displayed after the search. When I gave library, 73 plus crore links are listed. When I give knowledge, still 45 crore. So if you look at this, individually searching will not lead me to the right link which can provide me information. Then the other option is that I try with the combination of all together, the knowledge management libraries together as in search box, still I get 1 crore links. if you look at, you can see that 10 million hits to go through by an individual user is not an easy job. So finally, where we are landing is the kind of pollution of information, information pollution. I just like to call it as, because information is correct, but you are getting abundant information where we are not sure where to pick it up. This will be the fate of all research scholars or students when they search for anything. Now, easiest way is use Google for searching, or any other Yahoo, AltaVista, Ask Jeeves, Bing, any other kind of search engine for searching. But better that, go to an authenticated site and get the right information, like a university website or journal and database website, in addition to going, so that the search will be restricted to a particular area or domain which is very authenticated. So we can tell that InfliBNet Center works as a one-stop portal for all your information needs for the academicians and research scholars. This is, I'm referring about the educational content, research article, journal articles, full text thesis, bibliographic of books, thesis, videos, serials, expert databases, project databases. These are some of our video content. These are some of the content which InfliBNet keeps on adding to its fold so that it becomes one-stop portal for your information base. So for the research pursuit, support is what InfliBNet is meant for. And I earlier mentioned you can go with Google. And I caught some example that Google may not give you result all the time correctly. 3-4 years back, I tried to search Google with miserable failure. And the result I received was that the White House link, whitehouse.gov/president was the link it displays on top of it. The president of United States, George W. Bush, or the biography of Jimmy Carter, is linked to miserable failure, one of the unscrupulous programmer, by misleading the result. So that time Google search result could be manipulated. And in the overall pages of president or Jimmy Carter, you will not see anywhere miserable failure is used. So this is the funny or trick of a programmer, because Google is treated as a intelligent search engine. In that context, Google will also keep tracks of where from people are coming or what for people are asking for. So if you write a small script to submit to Google that miserable failure, whatever is linked, it should go to president's website, and execute this in a loop, that means many times Google feel that this word is associated. Such kind of lacuna was there with the search engine. So in that time, if this result was referred as an authenticated source, the researcher will be landing in trouble. So such kind of activities, in our term, we call it as Google bombs. The result manipulated by some programmer to mislead information. So it is better that we go to the authenticated website first. So learning generally happens with a different level: data collection, acquisition, gathering, data discovery. When it is processed, we call it as information. Processed data is information, or data which is having relevancy, timeliness, everything is called information. InfliBNet, the first I stand for information. So information at the right time to the right user can help to take right decisions. Now, information, if it is leading to decision making, that can be called as knowledge. So knowledge needs a database in the background, plus experience and some kind of inferences on the search results. These three are data, information, knowledge is the learning curve. And at the end, what suppose somebody is supposed to get is the wisdom. So we process data and get information. Information library network works on providing this information in the right track to the user. So that's why we can even refer information InfliBNet, some of our resources are the knowledge discover. It can be used for discovering the knowledge of particular topic. So the learning resources are basically books. In the old days, teacher was the learning resource. Then it become the textbook, then reference book, then institutional repository. That means the content created by the institution in their repository, which is openly available for others to access. In addition to that, you have the other tools, content management system and all, to manage the data. So in nutshell, InfliBNet services are centered about the core activities, which was mentioned in the objective, and 15 years back, InfliBNet came into existence in 1996, and it registered as a society in autonomous society in 1996, and it started as a project in 1991. So when we are looking back, InfliBNet is having almost an existence of 25 years. So whatever objective was set that time, the technology has developed much better. So InfliBNet is looking forward to implement some of the new initiative without deviating from its basic objective of providing information. Now, in this context, the core activities InfliBNet context since beginning was library automation, database management system, database management of union catalog, content subscribing through from various sources and distributing. It is called UGC InfoNet Digital Library Consortium under the name UGC InfoNet. Then connectivity, once we provided. Now NKN has rolled out to the nation with higher bandwidth and speed. InfliBNet has gradually migrated all its connectivity to the National Knowledge Network, NKN network. Then training part of it, human resources and ICT skill development. InfliBNet keenly watching. This was the core activities InfliBNet is doing in past, now also it is doing with a much more better way. In addition to that, InfliBNet has started last couple of years, maybe 10 years, new initiative like open access management, bibliometric studies, EPG Padashala, which is all very recent, 3-4 years old, UGC schemes, collaborative projects, expert databases called Vidwan, E-Ajarya, EPG Padashala, ICSSR data repository, NLIST, Shodh Ganga, Shodh Gangotri, OJS. All these are coming in as a new initiatives. I will also like to refer, when the time comes, we received some of the honor and awards in between. And ultimately, InfliBNet service will provide the capacity building platform for university librarians, academicians, and research scholars. We have our physical infrastructure located in Gandhinagar, which is amidst many prestigious institutions in the country, like very close to National Institute of Fashion Technology, National Institute of Design, Postgraduate PG campus, DAICT and TCS. These are some of the institutions very close to it. DAICT and TCS, close to our institution. So InfliBNet is an academic ambience in Gandhinagar, and also it is located in the InfoCity, Gandhinagar. And the infrastructure is built in such a way that we have walk-in user facility for the users. We do have the sophisticated network, that is low voltage IT solutions, which is based on 40G ready network, 100G roadmap for the coming years. The infrastructure also has that virtualized this layer 3 switch, firewall, IP telephony, building management system, CAD7A based structured cabling scheme, CCTV for security, HA firewall, high level, high availability firewall in redundancy mode, 2 internet connectivity, one from NKN, another from BSNL, and the other sophisticated servers in the data center. All these constitute our infrastructure, IT infrastructure. In addition, we have space more than 1 lakh square feet and residence compliant with an auditorium, state-of-the-art auditorium, and training rooms, modern classrooms, meeting rooms, scientist cabins, video conferencing. Everything is available, which is required for a new ICT institution, higher education institution in the country. So I will not be talking much on the physical infrastructure rather than go to the services which everybody can get through the website. But you are welcome to visit InfliNet Center for your information need. We were talking about web. So InfliNet, all activities are centered around website. Web 1.0, if you know that, in 1969, when ARPANET was established, which was the basic of internet, by connecting four universities, University of Los Angeles, Stanford, Utah, and another university. All these universities started connecting each other, which was later developed as internet. Now, 1972, email was invented. 1990, World Wide Web was invented by Tim Berners-Lee. Sir Tim Berners-Lee is known as the man or founder of this World Wide Web. Since then, library also started using this technology, because www is nothing but interconnection of web links, documents, that is the resources. 2005, Web 2.0 was introduced. Since 2.0 talks about the interactive web rather than the static web which mentioned in Web 1.0, lot of technology came into existence, which include blog, social networking, mashups, video streaming like YouTube. Now, all this RSS feed, all this becomes part of the 2.0 technology, interactive web, rather than just statically load the content and pulling it. 2.0 gives lot of interaction over it. Blog, you can understand, Wikipedia is one of the child of this 2.0 technology. People, the content is created by the wikis, that is people in a common platform, and the workflow manages that only authenticated content will be appearing in this platform. So like that, interactive, collaborative, dynamic web becomes the part of 2.0. And all models in our society, all kind of people in the society started using 2.0 technology. This was introduced by Tim O'Reilly. You can recollect business 2.0, or nowadays selling, buying, all things happening over website. eBay is an example of that. Amazon is an example of that. Snapdeal is an example of business 2.0. Or even you can see that the old used gadget, furniture or anything can be sold through this 2.0 technology. OLX is very successful for managing that. All this happened on web on an interactive mode. So business 2.0 becomes successful in this model, web 2.0. Then travel 2.0, make my trip, travel, clear trip, all this becomes part of traveling industry, become part of, adopted the technology of 2.0. So if all domains are accepting it, why not library accept this concept of 2.0? So Michael Casey in 2006 coined the library 2.0. So InfliNet use this 2.0 technology wherever is possible to provide information. So we have a challenge now as a librarian, because you, all of you are librarians. The challenge is that tomorrow librarian will be 2.0, because you cannot stay out of technology, because you are interacting with the user and the citizen of this country they will be also known as 2.0, citizen 2.0. So when the work of technology along with the its use is used by all the people in the society, definitely any model like library cannot keep away from that. So library used this concept and library 2.0 was introduced. Library 2.0 is nothing but web 2.0 plus the library concept. That is modernized form of library service that reflects a transition within the library world in the way services are delivered to the user. The application of concept technologies of web 2.0 applied to the library services and collection. More than the user focused web, user satisfaction is more important in 2.0. So feedback is one of the key which was lacking in library. Still, if we one book, if we go and take it, we are not very sure that how many people have read it. Maybe you will get the number by looking at the issue register, but who else has used it? What is their comment on the book, which is still not there? If 2.0 technology is properly used in library automation packages, this can happen. So InfliBNet initially started library automation by giving fund to 142 universities, later 24 universities. This enabled universities in 9th and 10th plan to automate their library and give their union database, bibliographic details, database of catalog into InfliBNet Center. So by giving funds and grants, InfliBNet tried to help the universities to build their collections in the soft copy. That means not digitization, but the bibliographic records. And part of this, we also provided some IT infrastructure LAN and requested the university to use the common standards and finally contribute their catalog into the union catalog of InfliBNet, that is IndiCat, Indian catalog. So Indian catalog emerged out of this scheme of library automation, where one place all universities catalog will be available. So IndiCat is similar to WorldCat, but restricted to only Indian catalog. All universities can contribute into our union catalog. About 160 plus universities has contributed. 75 lakhs records are unique records in lakhs of books. 75 lakhs books records are very unique in Indian IndCat. And this is taken from about 1.3 crore books data. And because many of the multiple copies are available in many universities, so we have unique of 75 lakhs records. So IndCat helps two ways. One is it becomes a single point of search for all the books available in the country. Second, it also provides duplication of effort. It also eliminates the duplication of effort. How it is eliminating? Because any book, if a university or college purchase, the bibliographic records which is required to be cataloged is already entered in our IndCat. So they can download this record. So time and space timing, 75 lakh books are there. It means almost all books. We feel that 95% of the books in the country will be covered in this database. The rest of the book, if it is new, if it is not found here, they have an option to upload that record into IndCat. And IndCat also holds books, thesis, serial, Vidwan, that is expert database, and video recording of CEC. All these are available in CAT. We also tried to create a Northeast special catalog, NECAT, and also Gujarat, being located in Gujarat state, GujCAT, where all institutions in Gujarat can contribute it. So IndCat is growing, and from its structure, with a rare distinction that this is the open catalog of books available and one of the biggest catalog in the world. And people can generally, creation of one record costs 25 to 30 rupees per record. If the record is available free of cost in InfliBNet, they can save money also. Time also, money, time, and infrastructure. So that is what is part of this union catalog. We also try to create authoritative records for places, like places, city name, because people enter one city name in different ways. And this becomes the one of the old project in InfliBNet, and it is still growing. Other one is called the library automation software. Many universities were looking for the automation software. The proprietary software was very, very costly. So InfliBNet tried to develop a software in 1996. It was under DOS-based platform. In 2000, this is converted into Windows-based. Then 2001, upgraded, and it is released as SOL, Software for Libraries, University Libraries. So SOUL, Software for University Libraries. So that is, so many people or universities and institutions started using it, and it became very, very popular in the country. And we had to update it in 2009 to release at 2.0, SOL 2.0. Now many of the major universities in the country, like Bombay University, MS University, Baroda, with a collection of more than 5 lakh books records, they are using SOL software for effectively managing their library. And the next version, web-based SOL software or cloud on SOL, is under process by InfliBNet Center. That development work is going on. So SOL is a state-of-the-art library management software. More than 3,000 installations are available now in the country. And we also regularly conduct training program for SOL software in InfliBNet Center, 5 days training program. And this software is also recommended by many state and adopted as a software in Madhya Pradesh, Haryana, Andhra Pradesh, etc. Some of the assembly libraries also using SOL software. Then connectivity, I told it is already shifted. Other one is UGC InfoNet Digital Library Consortium Journals. That is 8,500 electronic journals are available from 29 publishers, which include university presses, scholarly societies, commercial publishers, aggregators. 11 bibliographic databases are used. And name any popular journal, either it is Oxford University Press, Cambridge University Press, American Chemical Society, Annual Reviews, Institute of Physics, Society for Industrial Mathematics, IAM, Royal Society of Chemistry, Economic and Political Weekly, Springer, Taylor and Francis. You name any, most used electronic journals in universities are under our fold. And this is given to the universities absolutely free of cost. IP-based access is possible. Any campus computer in a university can directly access without login. But that IP address is to be authenticated, which is already done by many of the universities. And colleges, we have a special offer in the similar model. Almost 6,500 electronic journals are given under the scheme called NLIST. NLIST fund for National Library Information Library Infrastructure for Scholarly Content. NLIST offer journal as well as ebook. There are about 1.2 lakhs, earlier it was 98,000, but 1.2 lakhs books, ebooks available in NLIST. Any college, they can directly subscribe to this by paying a very nominal fee to InfliBNet Center. About 4,000 colleges are right now using, more than 5 lakh users are there on this NLIST scheme. This NLIST got 3 awards in past, that is E India Award, it got S-Coach Award, it got, and one more award national level because of the innovations. And there are many colleges which are using. Now training is one of the important concept in InfliBNet. We have regular planning of events. Kindly visit our website www.infliBNet.ac.in for more details, because yearly calendar of training program is released in the month of January. And they can also contact our HRD division for more details. And we regularly, every month, we have 1 or 2 programs in our center. About 50,000 people we have trained so far in ICT and LIS skills. And still it is going on. And under new initiative, these are the core activities which I mentioned. New initiative, we have a program called Shodh Ganga, which the concept is on free and open access. InfliBNet always focus on open source, open access, and open standard. So we are towards an open movement. In this context, we have Shodh Ganga, a repository of Indian electronic thesis and dissertation, absolutely free. People can download, people can browse, people can search, people can read anything. All these are the full text thesis. As on date, there are 65,000 full text thesis available free of cost for the research community. Then we have Shodh Gangotri, which is the ongoing research detail, that is research, Indian research in progress detail. Then we have open general access system, then InfliBNet repository with all publication, the info portal, then something E. Acharya and EPG Padashala, etc. Now, Shodh Ganga website address is shodhganga.infliBNet.ac.in. There are four kinds of searches in Shodh Ganga: symbol search, advanced search, subject search, and using Google API search. The new interface will give you all that. And the topmost university which contribute, as on date, 245 universities has signed MOU for Shodh Ganga. And 64,500 theses are there as on second week of January 2016. And it is increasing. 2010 only the project started. First 2-3 years, we have hardly 1,000 plus additions. But last year, 2015, we have 30,000 theses added. This year, we are much more expecting, maybe 50,000 theses will be added in 2016. So 1 lakh is a dream figure which we are keeping for Shodh Ganga in future. All tutorials are available in Shodh Ganga website. Regular training is conducted for Shodh Ganga. And under Shodh Ganga, 3 schemes are also there. Fund for digitization of old theses, setting up of lab, access to anti-plagiarism software. Now many universities got fund for this. About 80 universities we have recommended. 12 crore rupees already allocated on this. And every month it is growing. We also keep track of the usage statistic of Shodh Ganga. The topmost viewer is almost 11,000 views on the thesis, which is a thesis submitted to Shodh Ganga from a remote area from Tamil Nadu. That means it is not important that where the research or PhD is conducted, but the visibility is more even for the content which is from rural area. So one of the topmost thesis viewed in top 5 was from a district called Tirunelveli. And Shodh Ganga received E India Jury Choice Award in the year 2011. And the award was given to InfliBNet Center by Smriti Irani, who is the HRD minister now, in charge of UGC and InfliBNet. Now, we have a provision from INCAT, which is having bibliographic database. There are 2.53 lakhs bibliographic records of thesis. If full text is available, it will pick up from Shodh Ganga and display it. So that is some of the features of Shodh Ganga: customized injection interface, advanced search, browse option, control also can be alphabetically order listing of theses, and the structure of university is maintained. Even regional language theses are uploaded, which is available. Metadata and content is available in regional languages. A search in the content may not be possible because content is not in the standard Unicode form. Otherwise, regional language thesis can be browsed in Shodh Ganga website. And I have language thesis from Tamil, Malayalam, Gujarati, Hindi, Arabic, Urdu, then Canada, all this thesis, Gujarati. This many thesis we have already incorporated into. Then Shodh Gangotri is a complementary project to supplement Shodh Ganga. The research which started and approved synopsis, that so people will come to know what is the research going on. And since it is a voluntary submission, we don't have more than 2,000 submissions are there. Synopsis are uploaded into Shodh Ganga 3. Now in future, we will try to enhance it Then we have a platform called OJS for hosting the journal of universities and colleges. If anybody wants this free platform, they have to sign. But we check for the quality of the content first. One or two issues will be sent to the expert to see the quality. If it is okay, then we provide this platform. They can publish their periodicals regularly on our platform, OJS. Right now, we have about 16 journals, open access journal on this OJS platform. Then we have IR, part of our repository, all our publication, everything is put into this institutional repository. Calibre is an international convention. Planner is a convention held in Northeast, promotion of library automation in Northeast region. Every 2 years we conduct this program. It's proceeding in past. Was Calibre approximately 16 calibers finished. All content is available in our IR. Then bibliometric studies, the usage of the journal, article, etc. used by universities under INFLIBNET scheme. It's been analyzed as part of bibliometric studies. That is also a division in our department. INFLIBNET Center right now also maintained UGC website and the e-scholarship scheme. Whenever anybody want to apply for scholarships and the UGC scheme, the request come to INFLIBNET Center into our website because we maintain it. But all this process is done by UGC as per the rule. Our job is to only provide the platform to register by the students, and the detailed summary will be given to UGC, and the control is also to the UGC officials, and ultimately the report is generated. And this has made scholarship application, etc. Within a short of 15 days, UGC will be able to announce the result by using the platform. And they are using it. And one of the very important new program is EPG Padashala. Ministry of HRD under its NMEICT allocated fund to UGC for development of e-content in 77 subjects at the postgraduate level. So we have chosen the subject called social science, arts, humanity, natural, mathematical science, linguistic and language, and started developing the modules. And there are many video content available in EPG Padashala. More than 4,000 video contents, which are in four quadrants. Self-learning, reading material, that is e-text, then self-analysis, that is for test purpose, that is there. Then reference. These four quadrants are there in every module of 30 minutes. And that same concept is also borrowed for this building, this NML training program. And INFLIBNET is collaborating with many other agencies. Expert database is one that is called Vidwan. If you are an expert in the country, there is a definition for expert that is available in our website. If you are having an experience of so many years in life, teaching field, maybe assistant professor or and above, or senior scientist, they can register as an expert. So right now we have 16,000 experts available in expert database. Soon it will be touching 20,000. So Vidwan is an expert database and national research network. Then we have who can join in the Vidwan, and a postgraduate or doctor degree in the respective division and associate professor or senior scientist. Then national or international awardees and citation laureates, all these people can register themselves. So that people looking for an expert, they can come to our Vidwan database and choose it. Vidwan also having a tool called Vivo. That means if you have published article with an ORCID ID, and if you are visible as a researcher with an ORCID ID, that can pick up data from ORC ID and put into Vidwan. So all these are some of the major services. And INFLIBNET received 4 awards, which I mentioned. Shodh Ganga received Ejurichandra Award. NLIS received Escoach Award, Manthan Award, E-India Award. This our services. And we have also recognized at the international level on ranking of website for research center portal. Repositories, Shodh Ganga is recognized in the repositories category. And I will also try to take the latest development in INFLIBNET Center, which happened in last 3-4 months time. ICSSR, Indian Council for Social Science Research, they have a huge data repository. That repository, they were looking for hosting somewhere, and now this, the responsibility of a repository is given to InfliBNet Center. So we have presently content from about 27 research institutes, 6 regional centers. And it is created for the social science research with free availability of data to everyone for use. And anybody, any public library or any citizen, they can access this free, of course. This data also include this the statistical data, demographic data, and social science data. You understand what would be the data type on that. All data which is available and authenticated, it is available. Now, this platform come to the data service set of InfliBNet website. So many data sets are available, university data is available, and InfliBNet is regularly updating it. Recently, we received a project called National Institutional Ranking Framework, NIRF. NIRF tried to rank the institute. So it is starting with IITs and engineering colleges now. So we made the framework, which are the parameters which are defined by the committee, National Accreditation Board. And that, by based on that, institute has developed a interface for filling data for ranking purpose. So that is also there. The parameter, etc., you can read from our website. Category of institutions. This ranking is university, colleges, engineering, management, pharmacy, architecture, any discipline. This is possible. Indian university ranking also, IRU. About 160 universities are ranked overall with 8 subject domain. And ranked university can be sorted by type of university with a state. So engineering type, medical health, central university, state university, we can different geographical region, southeast, western region, central. Everywhere we can see which is the best university in parameter as decided by the parameter decided by the committee or UGC. So Indian university of in various world ranking, this is also available. And at the end, some of e-Acharya, which will be a portal for giving all the content to the academicians. So content is generated by all institutions like NPTEL, video content generated by IIT Bombay, EPG Padachala, or the text content, videos of ECEZ, everything will come into one portal. And it could be video content, audio content, text material, course material. UGC is also thinking of now creating the massive online courses, MOOC. And InfliBNet is going to play a major role in that. In nutshell, I just want to tell that with its all project, integrated e-content portal like e-Acharya, PG Padashala, everything, InfliBNet is making a platform for the research community and students in the country for effectively searching and getting the right information, which could be any academic content or which could be even the data content like social science data. So InfliBNet will work as a one-stop portal for all the information needs for students and academic community in the country. And many of the projects are open for public, as we don't have any restriction, since InfliBNet is following the open access mode. And public librarians also can use many of our services free of cost. With this, I once again welcome you to our website to see more information and use our services effectively and be the ambassador or torchbearer of InfliBNet Center wherever you promote the information access. Thank you very much.